Hello guys, my name is Mohammad Naveed and in this lecture I will tell you what is MS Access and how to create a database. But before we learn how to create a database, first we had better know what is MS Access. Well, MS Access is a database management system and it is used for managing a data. You might be familiar with Microsoft other products like MS Word, MS Excel, and you may have a strong hold in Excel. And you are thinking, why should I learn MS Access when I already know Excel? Well, MS Excel is good for small database, but when it becomes huge, it is hard to manage in Excel. On the other hand, MS Access is designed for managing a huge databases, and it is easy to learn. And as you know, this is an introduction to MS Access. Therefore, in this lecture, we will just learn how to create a database. So let's learn the way of creating a database. In order to create a database, first we have to click on blank desktop database. As you click, the one window will appear and asking the name of your database. You can give the name what you like. In this case, I am giving NaveedPlace.com. And then we can browse, means we can change the location of our MS Access file, but I don't want to change the location of my MS Access file. Therefore, I will not click on it. If you want to, just click on browse for a location to put your database. Click on it, and you can save your database wherever you want. When you completely given your name, click on OK. And congratulations, you have successfully created a database. So this was an introduction to MS Access. In the next lecture, we will learn how to create tables. Tables are the backbone of any database, whether it is an Excel, MySQL, or MS Access. You'll find tables in any database. So let's learn tables. In order to create a table, we need to come at the left hand side of MS Access and then click on tables, right click, and then again click on design view. As you click on design view, you will ask to save your table and give the name. So for example, here I am giving students. It can be any name, or you can say Naveed, it will be much better, Naveed Place, and then click on OK. As you can see, I have three columns. First is field name, second is data type, and third is description. Field name means the name of the column. As you know, tables have columns and rows. For those who don't know what am I talking about, this is for them. I have opened MS Excel. As you can see, in MS Excel we have columns and rows. Columns, one, two, three, and rows, the line which is going from left to right, one, two, three, four. So this is called row and this is called column. Here in MS Access we are creating columns. We are creating column. For example, ID, name, and course. So for example, here I'm giving second column name, that is names, and third is course. So this is called field name, means column names. Now we must talk about data types. Data type means what kind of data will be inside of this column. Let's take an example of an ID. If I open again MS Excel, as you can see, we have ID. In ID, we are not allowed to put characters. For example, like Naveed. If I write here Naveed, due to the fact it is an ID and it is required number. For example, we say here 1, that will be correct. If we say 2, that will be also correct. And if we say 3, that will also correct. So means we required number, not the character. So this is a way that we determine that what kind of data is suitable for the column. Now I suppose you have understood what is mean by data type. So let's learn data type. For example, if we talk about the ID, so in ID we need the ID number. For example, one. For example, if I write something, so I want an automatic, for example, ID. For example, as I write FB or anything, so it should come here an ID. So I want an automatic. So automatic means that whenever I enter, you can say as soon as I enter any number or any entry, it will automatically generate an ID. So it's called auto number. Then we have the short text. Short text means that if you are giving the field to your user for the short text, just like username or username and like this. Then we have the long text. Long text is used for example, for comments. For example, if you are giving the field to your user for comments, so this is a long field, means long text is required. Number, you know, date and time. For example, if you are giving this field to your user for date and time, so this data time, currency, you know, auto number, I. So there are many data type, but you no need to take tension right now, because if you are not getting what I told you, so this not mean that if you go further and further, and definitely it will be easy for you to understand. After giving the names and after creating tables and tables columns, I will definitely double click on navidplace.com, and again I will be asked to save my table columns. So I will definitely click on yes, and I have successfully created table columns, as you can see, ID, names and course. We are going to learn how to insert a data. In order to insert a data, definitely I will come below the names and I will type the name. It can be any name, for example Naveed, and for course I will do same, for example MS Office. As you can see that even though we have three fields, but I am just using, or I am just working on two fields. Why am I doing this? Because as you remember in the last lecture, we made ID as an auto number. So whenever I type or whenever I insert any new entry, it will automatically generate ID or number. So for example, if I want to add a new, for example, entry, so for example Kamran, and then it can be hardware, and then again, and if I say for example Ali, so you can see that it generates automatically. And for example, if I say that computer, so in this way, this is the way to insert our data. The best way to insert our data is to create form. In order to create form, definitely I will click on form, create, and then click on form. As I click, you can see that now I am in the new world. This is the world of form. So this is the way, and this is the way to insert data. Definitely, we will definitely go into detail of form in the next lecture, but in this lecture I just want to let you know that we have three ways to see form. It is very similar to table, but this is not the proper way. The proper way is form. So for example, if you click on view, so we have three views. The first is form view. What is the work of form view? Form view means that you will not be able to change, for example, you will not able to change, or you will not able to resize, or you will not able to do anything like this. But if I click on, you can say layout view, so in this view, I am able to change the size. For example, if I want to change the size, or if I want to move any of the, field, definitely I can do this. For example, if I want to change the size, I can do this. The last we have, that is called design view. What does it mean by that? Design view means that by the design view, we can design our form, and if we can make our form a user-friendly form, and definitely we can make it much more better. I will teach you how to use form. As you remember, in the last lecture we learned how to insert data in our MS Access, and as I told you that we have two ways of inserting a data. The first way is by table, and the second way is by form. And we also learned that inserting a data by a table, this is not a right way. The proper way and a correct way of inserting a data is by form. So let's learn form. In order to learn form, I will click on create and then I will click on form. As I click on form, as you can see that now I am in the new world and this is the world of a form. And as you can see that form has its own three menus. The first is design, second is arrange, and the third is format. Before we learn what is design, I just want to let you know that what you mean by form. Definitely you are thinking that sir is teaching us form, but he has not told us that what is mean by form. Actually, form means that the environment, or for example, the options or button you see. For example, if you talk about MS Access, so you can see that MS Access has, you can say menus and all buttons and all this thing. But we don't know what kind of language or what kind of coding Microsoft use. We don't know. But just Microsoft is just allowing us to just click and definitely use this menu. In a similar way, when we are creating form means that it will show to the user, or it will show to the definite user. User will not know that, okay, what is inside of this form and what kind of technology have you used, how many tables are in this form. He is not concerned with about all this thing. He only knows that what is mean the form, and he will only work on the form. Me as it is, as we are working on MS Access. So for example, this is a thing which user will see. So the first thing we will do in the design, definitely what is mean a design, definitely to design something. And in this lecture we will learn how to design our, you can say, form. So the first you can say menu or the option of design menu is view. What is meant by view? View means that how do you want to view your form. We have three ways of viewing our form. The first way is form view, second is layout view, and third is design view. Form view means that in the form view you are not allowed to do anything. For example, if I want to change the size, or if I want to work, if I want to put any formula, so I am not allowed to put any of these things because I am in the form view. So form view means that I am not allowed to do anything. Again, we'll go in the form view and then we'll go for layout view. What is mean by layout view? Layout view means that in the layout view we are allowed to change the size. For example, if I want to change the size of my of my field, and let's suppose if I want to move, or if I want to keep my form here or anywhere. For example, if I want to change the size, so if I click on layout view, so in the layout view I am allowed to change the position or location of my form, or you can say I'm also able to change the size. Totally mean the layout. Then we have the most important is design view. In the design view we can put the formula and all this. For example, events in a formula as like a real software. So in the design view we are allowed to put the formula and events, all this thing. So in this lecture we will just learn the design, how to design our form. So we will not go into the formula session. So this is just for design. So the first thing we have for the design is the themes. What does it mean about theme? Theme means that how do you want to see. For example, it is a mixture of colors and fonts. MS Access already made the mixture of both for us, and that is in the form of theme. For example, let's suppose if you want this theme, if you are able to see that it is changing, something is changing here. Are you able to see the changing? If I click, you can see that now it has been changed. So whenever I want to change, I will definitely hover any of the theme and I will click, and that will be my theme. And if I want to change the color, I can change the color. If I want to change the font style, for example Arial Black, which I like. So for example, if I want to change the font style, so I can change my font style here. Are you getting me? Then we have for example, in the drop down we have all the buttons and all this thing. So the first thing you will see that is what we call radio buttons. Radio buttons are very useful when we have to select one of the options. For example, if we are asking from the user that are you male or female. For example, if asking gender. For example, if you are entering the data, so we have to put the data in our database that the person is either a male or female. So for example, if you want to make the something like this, so definitely you can use radio button. For example, if I want to say male or female. For example, if I'm asking from the user that are you male or female, so for example male or female, and then I will go in order to see any of the changes which we made in design view. So I will click on form view. In the form view, it will show the real life. In the real life, we see as the user, we see in the real. So in the form view, we can see that how will it look in the real. So for example, if I want to ask from the user are you male or female, for example it now is clicking both, but definitely we'll put the functionality that it will be only select one of the option. For example, if you want to put like this any of the you can say radio buttons, if you want to put the button, for example if you click on buttons, so click anywhere, and here we have you can say buttons option. For example, if you want to put the button for record navigation, for example find next record, go to the first, go to the last record. For example, if you are at the first record, now you want to go to the second record, definitely you will click on first record. If you are on the second record and you want to go you want to see the first record, so you can click on the last record. For example, record option, if you want to put the functionality for the user that if the user will click on this button, so that will allow the user to add a new record. For example, if I click on next, and definitely if I go again the form view, now I have a button. For example, if I click on this button, that it will allow me to put a new for example, insert a new entry. For example, if I say here Naveed, and code can be MS Access, and if I want to put again, definitely I can insert a new data. So in this way, we can put the functionality to a form for the user. For example, anywhere you want. For example, we have a number of options, or you can say operations. We have form operation, close form. If you want to close the form, if you want to make the reports, we will go in the letter you can say lectures. For example, if you want to put the functionality that if any user will click on this button, so the application will be closed. So in this way, you can put a lot of functionality for the user that whenever user will click, something will happen. So this is by buttons. So there are many buttons, but you are not only allowed to use pre-coded buttons. We can also put our own functionality. For example, if you want to calculate the marks, or if you are making a mark sheet, if you want to get the percentage of any user, so definitely we can also put that functionality. But we will learn this in the later lecture. So in this way, we can make our form more better, more interactive. So this was